diesel power plant. When it comes down to generation of electricity, that is electric power, it is essential to rotate the rotor of an alternator by prime mover. This prime mover can be driven using different types of fuel. Diesel engine is one of the most popular methods as a prime mover for generating electricity. So, when prime mover of an alternator is diesel engine, then the power station is known as diesel power station. Let's take a look at the diesel power plant. The various subsystems of a diesel power plant are prime mover, starting system, lubrication system, exhaust system, cooling system, air intake system, and fuel system. So let's learn about each of the subsystems in a bit more detail. In a diesel power plant, prime mover is a two-stroke or a four-stroke multi-cylinder diesel engine. The starting system. Starting system provides the initial rotation to the engine shaft required to start the engine. Smaller units can safely be started manually by hand cranking. However, larger units use compressed air for starting purpose. Lubrication system. Lubrication system consists of lubricating oil tank, pump, filter, and oil cooler. Lubricating oil is drawn from the oil tank by the pump and is passed through filters to remove impurities. Oil coolers are also there to keep temperature of the oil as low as possible. Exhaust system. As the name suggests, leads the engine exhaust gases out to the atmosphere. A silencer is used to reduce noise level. Air intake system. Intakes the air and supply it to the engine for fuel combustion. Its air filters remove dust from air before forwarding it to the engine. Air filters can be dry type, made up of wool or cloth. Fuel system. Fuel system consists of a storage tank or the main tank to store the fuel. The oil is pumped into the day tank via transfer pump. During the transfer, oil passes through the strainers or filters to remove solid impurities. Another pipe, called as overflow pipe, is available to connect the day tank to the main tank. It returns the oil from the day tank to the main tank in the event of oil overflows. Fuel injection pump injects the fuel from the day tank into the engine cylinder at a high pressure of about 100 bars. Cooling system. Cooling system is instrumental for the liquid cooling process. In this system, cooling jackets are provided on the engine cylinder walls and head through which the coolant is circulated. The heat is transferred from the cylinder walls to the coolant by the process of convection and conduction. The coolant heated during its passage through the cooling jackets is cooled while it passes through the air-cooled radiator. So this is how a diesel power plant works. Now let's go ahead and take a look at its advantages and disadvantages. Advantages. The plant layout is simple, which ensures quick installation and commissioning as compared to the steam or hydro power plant. Quick starting and easy pickup of loads in a very short span of time. Easy load operation and requires minimum labor. Simple fuel handling and efficient ash disposal. High level of efficiency. Disadvantages. The power generation capacity of these power plants is limited to about 50 megawatts. It is expensive as diesel fuel is expensive as compared to coal. Maintenance cost of a diesel power plant is also very high. Life of these power plants is relatively short. Recap. In this lesson, you learnt about different systems of a diesel power plant, how it works, and the advantages and disadvantages of diesel power plants.